we are seeing more than nearly three accidents yesterday during the startup of the company after the COVID lockdown. Why it happened? What are the problems that I won't discuss right now? Mainly, there are certain guidelines for startup as well as shutdown. Shutdown activity, it's not possible to shut down immediately any chemical plant as you like. You have to follow some procedures. Likewise, for starting of the plant also, you have to follow certain procedures. And any deviations or any problems arising during the startup period or shutdown period, that will lead to accident or incident or disaster. Normally, chemicals are important. Without chemical, it is not possible to live. Pharma industries need chemicals, textile industries need chemicals, plastic need chemicals, what not. Whatever area and every day usage of chemical is the part and part of our life. So chemical manufacturing is very, very important in any country's progress. It is also brings a lot of revenue, and the manufacturing sector, chemical industry also plays a big role. Any chemical industries, there is a risk. Without risk, no chemicals are there. Most of the major disaster in the industrial sector occurred in chemical industries. Mother of all accidents occurred in our country, in Bhopal, and HPCL accident at Vizag, and the current accident occurred yesterday in our industry at Vizag. So, risk involved in the chemical is very high. So, but because of the risk involved and problems in the manufacturing, we can't say that we don't want chemical. It's not possible. If we say no to chemicals, we can't have a medicine for any cure. It's not possible. So chemicals are more important. So chemical, we have to accept the chemical, the risk in the chemical manufacturing, and we have to minimize the risk as minimum as possible. We can't completely eliminate this. We have to reduce as maximum as possible. Whenever a new unit comes, the government is asking for a risk assessment report, environment impact analysis. The risk assessment report will tell how much kilometer or how much meter damage distance in case of any release of toxic gas or any explosion fireball radius. Intensity, everything will be told in the risk assessment. The government has to go in deep and allocate the land based on the risk assessment report, including the future expansion plan. Normally, unplanned expansion in the chemical plant also one of the negative thing. When the initial stage, the plant capacity is adequate and the adequate safety system will be there, space availability is very good. When expansion take place, those things are getting reduced. Because of the approval process, lengthy approval process, people prefer to go for expansion even though constrained in the available land rather than going for a new facility. Whenever they are going for new facility, there are lot of issues are there. We have nobody want a chemical industry near my area, my village. So people are against, the mentality of the people is totally against because of the accidents and risk. Nobody want to get killed, nobody want to get disease, nobody want to get spoiled because of the manufacturing. That is correct. Don't be correct. According to their perception, is correct. But at the same time, chemical industry also needed. Without chemical industry, it's not possible to live. So we have to find a way. That's the reason I'm telling. And whenever a chemical company coming to India or starting in India, they will be choosing a location where it is an isolated location, no 4 to 5 kilometers, no residence area will be there. Later stage, when the company start growing, lot of people get employed. One by one, small shop is coming, residence is coming, and that area getting developed. When I visited Union Carbide in the year 1978, there was no residence near them. When the accident occurred, lot of residence area nearby developed. Likely, the Vizag plant also yesterday, that when the plant was started, no residence area nearby, and no development was there. It is like a jungle. Now totally is different. We are permitting the residence area near the industries. Government has to stop. And industry also go to the court of law and get a stay for development. It is a very difficult task. That's the reason I am telling. The allotment of the land or land purchase itself, risk contour should not cross their boundary. That is a benchmark. The risk contour is under 1 kilometer. You purchase entire land 1 kilometer, and you have no right to transfer reliable to others. Entire land you purchase, and risk contour, entire risk contour your facility, your own land, so that it won't go as an offside emergency. The offside emergency, it is very difficult to handle and difficult to control. There are offside emergency plan we are making, and mostly the offside emergency is not functioning. Mark-till we are unable to Mark-till was not conducted for several years in almost all district because of the loss of people are not cooperating, or people are against this one. If they come to know this much chemical, this one life threat is there, they start working against the company. They want to close the company. That mentality is there. So the Mark-till is a big question mark as on date. So what I am telling is, no need of any Mark-till. If Mark-till, offside Mark-till, if this contour is within your premises, encourage industries to buy the land and allot the land and keep the risk inside the premises itself. Once it crosses outside, don't give permission for the expansion plan. Ask them to go for a new location. That's a good solution. Even emergency also, in case of emergency also, it will happen within few seconds, fraction of seconds, emergency will happen. Even most of the emergency, even Bhopal also, it happened in the night. Is it possible for the district collector to reach in a remote area in the midnight to control everything, to evacuate everything? Is humanly not possible. Even though we are making plan, we can make it. It may be in the books. Practically, it is not possible. So my sincere advice to reduce keep the damage distance within your boundary. This is a solution for new industries. New industries also, you can make a big complex, chemical complex. actually no human being or residence area permitted in that area. Plan for a common facility for storage. Supply this one common facility mid of the the complex, semi complex, so that contour, this contour will be within that industrial area itself. It won't go outside. You keep control over that, and what even you can spend whatever money you want to make a control system, because it is going to be shared by all the industries. For example, you fire hydrant facility, each and every company is storing 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, and all company not going to get fired in a single day. No fire is going to come. It's not possible. Fire, when a fire starts in a single company, suppose you got a common storage of fire water in a industrial complex, make use of it, and firefighting is easy. You have a common facility for storage, common facility firefighting, and you'll have a, you can spend more money, and you'll get experts for handling everything. For chemical emergency, you have a team of people round the clock. Our fire emergency, you keep the people round the clock. Anything, and you can all together, they can invest more. And if they are investment for the individual investment 100 rupees, a common investment going to cost, better investment going to cost only 30 rupees or 40 rupees. That way, the industry also will get benefited, the accident also can be avoided. So, offset emergency, the bird itself we have to remove from our this one. This is the one thing. And a common facility available, and the common facility experts team can be used for that chemical complex during the startup period. Pre-audit, you have to get approved by the team of experts sitting in a common facility before starting up your plant. And you must do the shutdown in front of them. They have to certify this. This will eliminate your disasters. It will reduce the probability of occurrence. This way, we can build a system. Okay, what we can do for the existing industries? Existing industries, why they are keeping the inventory high? You have to find the cause. Suppose your day production is 2 tons, why you are holding 100 tons? That's a question mark. Some industries are importing raw material. Every day it is not possible to import. So they are keeping huge stock. Okay, fine. Huge stock, it is absolutely necessary, you have to keep, know that go. What my recommendation is, keep the stock instead of one tank, 100 tons, you keep 10 tons in each tank, 10 tanks. So your release in case of accident is, instead of 100 tons, it is getting reduced to 10 tons. 10 ton or 5 ton, that you have to decide based on your risk assessment report. And the whatever the quantity, your risk assessment in case of accidental release within your boundary without crossing outside, you decide the inventory quantity. Inventory based on your risk assessment report. And you have to keep your tank pumps area and reactor center of your factory, not in the side of your factory. Most of the factories, the tendency of keeping the tank pump in one corner of the factory. That is not correct. Tank pump area should be center of the factory. Then only the risk contour will be within your boundary. It won't cross your boundary. We have your boundary, your firefighting, or any accident control, everything possible within your command. Once it crosses the compound, it is the power of district authority. And district authority, reaching that area is difficult. Mobilizing, suppose the accident occurs, they can reach minimum after an hour or so. That is, when they are reaching, they can't do evacuation, they can do only other things, compensation and other things. And
it's not possible. So reduce the inventory. That is the message I want to give. Okay, storage is concerned, it's okay. You reduce the level of storage and bring the controls, stringent controls on storage. Whatever manner, whatever interlocks you can provide, you can provide instrument control, you provide it. Second thing, wider use of the instruments also one of the factor for action, because we always depend on them and we are not using our intelligence, human intelligence. Human intelligence is the highest control system in this world. We are forgetting that we are not actually involving ourselves fully, because there is an instrument control. Instrument control also to be periodically verified, we have to make human control also parallel. One fails, other will take care. Here, we are entire thing we are leaving to the instrument control. Human control, we are not getting, making use. That's the reality as and then. So, better to have a parallel control, human control as well instrument control. Both together, we can able to control the things. This will definitely will improve the safety of the any plant. Next comes process safety. Process safety, reactor, maximum reactor. The accidents are either in the storage or in the reactors. What are the rules there for reactors as on date? Nothing. Anybody can manufacture reactor and any standard can be followed and no control, unless otherwise the individual company brings some control or third party inspection, legal requirements are not there. Likewise, there is no statutory inspection for the reactors, and reactor to be thoroughly checked every year. They are going to shut down and do the checking, and they would involve reputed third party person for checking the reactors. And fabrication also, like tank farm, if you go to the tank farm manufacturing, there is a piso is there, the unfired pressure vessel piso is there, fired pressure vessels boiler inspector is there. They will be approving the design of the vessel or boiler, fired pressure or unfired pressure vessel. They will going to the design qualification, they are appointing a third party, and third party controlling right from raw material up to dispatch of the tank. Entire thing controlled by a third party, control certificate issued. After installation also, the inspection procedures are there, whether it is done properly or not. These are the things we have to take in mind. It may be reactor, it may be pressure vessel, same rules should be applied. And second thing, the leakage quantity or vapor quantity, even if it is not harming, when it crosses the boundary, that's to reach the LEL level, lower explosive limit, even fire is not there also. If it crosses this one, it reach LEL level, that is more important. So the stringent rules should be framed for the reactors also. That is a missing link as on date. So one, tank farm and reactor safety is more important, and common facility and the elimination of the offsite emergency plan, this will definitely will improve the safety in chemical industries. One thing before conclusion, we got lot of opportunity to start a chemical industries in India. For example, pharma industries are importing 70% raw material from China. Most of the chemical industries are importing materials from China. There is a very good opportunity that to this post-corona or the corona era economic situation, this will be handy for economic development, stabilizing the economic, new industries in the chemical is also one of the area to be thought. So when you want a new industry, new investment, you have to create atmosphere for that, and fail-safe atmosphere to be created by government as well as the other legal bodies. Then only investment will come. Entrepreneurs, no entrepreneur, no factory manager, no worker or no engineer wants the action or instance. In spite of all these things, in spite of control system in place, and especially the Vizag industry got a stringent safety norms, very good engineers they got, very good management. In spite of that, it happened. I don't know why. They had taken everything seriously and do everything, corrective actions and all. They're second to none. But in spite of all these things, the accident occurred yesterday. But why? Because one point, human. Human, I'm talking about one example I'm giving. Somebody driving a vehicle. On the road is there, highway, you're going at speed of 70 kilometers, 60 kilometers, 80 kilometers and something. All of a sudden, he got heart attack. What will happen? He'll lose the control and go and hit. Because a human is driving the vehicle, because of his illness, sometimes he got giddiness immediately when driving also, uncontrolled manner, he goes and kills somebody. It is an accident. He has not deliberately done anything. Likewise, the human error, knowingly or unknowingly, it is possible. Sometimes reasons beyond his control, reason within control. Reason within control can be addressed by some training classes and making some system working and educating the particular operator and all the thing. And within control can be controlled, within control, within which is beyond control cannot be. That is a very, very minimum chances are there. So even it occurs also, the damage curve should not cross the boundary. That is my request to all the stockholders. With this, I conclude this. Thank you. Jai Hind.